to Bengal Field here in sunny Lewiston, Idaho for today's football game between the Orofino Maniacs and your Jenifer Burrows. Today's game is scheduled to be kind of a game of two halves. First half is scheduled to be the 7th grade team from Jenifer playing against the combined 7th 8th from Orofino. Second half is scheduled to be the Jenifer 8th grade against the combined 7th 8th of Orofino. So earlier today, the air quality was a little bit poor, upper 140s for the air quality index, but a nice breeze has come in and kind of blown the smoke out. Air quality is pretty good right now. So we're looking forward to a nice game here. The clock is showing about 20 minutes before kickoff, so we may get a little bit of a delayed start here. But we'll be here regardless and ready for a beautiful afternoon of football. So you can see from the waving American flag in the south end zone, there's just a nice breeze, temperature in the low 90s, so a little bit of a respite from the heat we had a few weeks ago, and just a great afternoon for some football. So while we're waiting for the game to start, we'll do a few introductions. So for Orofino, the combined team, we have Jason Rupi, number 80, number 40, Logan McCorkle, number 50, Luke Defoe, number 3, Sawyer Barnett, number 2, Caleb Kessinger, number 20, Casey Kimball, number 24, Cole Madsen. Number 72, Blaine Johnson. Devin Welch. Number 52, Mickey Cannon. Number 70, Ray Stars. Trayton Carlock. Number 10, Gavin Durkin. Number 32, Gavin Miller. 54, Colby Casker. 44, Adam Rasmussen. And number 4, Jeremy Saruta. For Orofino, their athletic director is Kathleen Turner, Principal Brian Lee, and Superintendent Dr. Michael Garrett. For Jenifer Junior High, 7th graders, the roster is comprised of number 6, Rylan Keller, 7, Christian Sproul, 13, Crew DeGroote, 14, Wyatt Eaton, 15, Dallas Richardson, 16, Baylor Hornby, 17, Noah Schumacher, 20, Tanner Wyatt, 21, Junior Moody, 23, Caden Howell, number 30, Max Elliott, 31, Jacob Vale, 34, David Miller, 41, DJ Wilkerson, 42, Canyon Underwood, 43, Rowan Harrison.
Well, welcome to Bengal Field for this afternoon's match between the Jenifer Burrows and the Orofino Maniacs. So, we're scheduled to have kind of a game of two halves today. First half is scheduled to be the Burrows 7th graders against the combined 7th and 8th grade from Orofino. And the second half, the combined 7th and 8th Morfino against the Burroughs 8th graders. The air quality is looking pretty good. It was a little bit smoky this morning, but a nice breeze has come in and blown a lot of the smoke out. You can see the flag waving nicely down in the southern end zone. On the clock, they have about 15 minutes until the game is scheduled to start. So I presume that's about correct. We were given about a 4 o'clock start time, so we may have just decided to start a little bit late today due to scheduling and everything. Looks like we're still waiting for officials to arrive too, so I wonder whether that is the reason for our slightly delayed start. This is going to be the first game of the season for Jennifer. I believe there was a game scheduled for yesterday at Orofino, and when the teams got there, the air quality had just dropped under the allowable level, so the game had to be canceled, and so that game was not able to be held. But the air has gotten quite nice this afternoon here in Lewiston. The air quality's improved a lot. So we've got an exciting season of football here. I believe we have about 9 or so games that we'll be able to bring you if everything works as we hope and plan. We appreciate you tuning in and cheering on your Burrows or your Orofino Maniacs for today's contest. We'll get a little bit of a look at Orofino warming up. So Orofino is coached by Daryl Perotti and Matthew Carlock. Jennifer, 7th grade, is coached by Ryan Peterson, Rick Fuentes, Tony Mastroberardino, and Warren Aiken. We'll go ahead and just cut back to some background music while we wait for the game to get underway. We're expecting the game to get underway in about 13 minutes. Yes. I'm not sure where, but I've seen him. I don't think so. So what I know of today's plan, I want to make sure. Good afternoon, and for those of you just tuning in, it appears that we are about 7 minutes from kickoff here today. For today's game between the Orofino Maniacs and your Jenifer Burrows. We'll return shortly. Well, good afternoon and welcome back to today's game between the Jenifer Burrows and the Orofino Maniacs. Looking at the clock, it looks like we'll get started in just a couple minutes here. The officials have come out of the locker room onto the field and are getting the chain crew all lined up on the far sideline. Cheerleaders are getting all warmed up on the near side. Jennifer's still warming up on the field, and Orofino has taken their spot on their sideline. Today's game will be a little bit a game of two halves. First half, seventh grade Jennifer against the combined team from Orofino, and second half will be eighth grade. So we thank you for tuning in today. The Burrows coaching staff is comprised of Ryan Peterson, Rick Fuentes, Tony Mastroberardino, and Warren Aiken. Administration is Justin Miller and Joanne Greer. For Orofino, they are coached by Daryl Perotti and Matthew Carlock. Their administration, Athletic Director Kathleen Tetweiler and Superintendent Michael Garrett. Principal Brian Lee. So air quality was possibly going to be an issue today. Earlier today it was fairly smoky and the air quality index was a little over 140. But a nice breeze has come through this afternoon and blown that smoke out. Air quality is quite good right now. Temperature's pretty nice. Upper 80s or lower 90s right now here down at Bengal Field. And if you're home deciding whether to come on out, come on out. It's beautiful out here this afternoon.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Bengal Field and our first little split scrimmage between the Jennifer Burrows and the Orofino Middle School Maniacs. Our first half will be Jennifer's seventh grade against Orofino. Our second half, after a 15-minute break, will be our Jennifer eighth grade against Orofino. At this time, we ask that you rise and remove your covers for the playing of our national anthem. Our flag is located in the southern end zone by the scoreboard. Thank you. At this time, we'll do the captain's meetings and coin toss. The concession stand will be open here in moments. The cash box is on its way down from LHS. Thank you for modeling good sportsmanship and go Burrows.
Thank you.
I'm good. All right, we're getting ready to do our coin toss. Working out a few issues here with our online scoreboard. And I believe we've resolved that. So we've got a fairly exciting season planned right now. A number of home games. We'll talk through some of that schedule here in a little while. I believe we're going to be able to bring you 9 or 10 home or games here for the Burrows from Bengal Field. All their home games, in addition to likely the game that Sacagawea hosts, also here at Bengal Field. So we'll go ahead and introduce as much of the roster as we can here before we get underway. For Jenifer, Rylan Keller, Christian Spruill, Crew DeGroot, Wyan Eden, Dallas Richardson, Baylor Hornby, Noah Shoemaker, Tanner Wyell, Junior Moody, Caden Howland, Max Elliott, Jacob Vale, Daly Miller, DJ Wilkerson, Canyon Underwood, Rowan Harrington, Ramsey Bashaw, Caden Moreland, Blake Davis, Silas Height, Dylan Halbert, Cody Thompson, Gunnar Robinette, Braden Wall, Paul Dam, Spencer Sutton, Max Gernert, Carson Merle, Max Storm, Sam McFarland, Cade Cameron, Lewis Fisher, Braylon Howland, Cameron Martin, and Soyvon McCaskey. For Orofino, Jackson Rupee, Logan McCorkle, Luke Defoe, Sawyer Barnett, Caleb Kessinger, Casey Kimball, Cole Madsen, Blaine Johnson, Devin Welch, Mickey Cannon, Ray Stars, Trayton Carlock, Gavin Durkin, Gavin Miller, Colby Casker, Adam Rasmussen, and Jeremy Serrata. Looks like we have a pretty good crowd here. I estimate around 100, 150 on the home side, and probably 25 or so made the trek down from Orofino to watch from the visitor side. Right, and we'll have our captains go out and meet midfield. It appears that our captains for today, for Jenifer, Number 80, Cade Cameron. Number 15, Dallas Richardson. And number 66, Spencer Sutton. It appears Luke Defoe and Ray Stars are two of the captains for Orofino. We'll try to get a third name here in a moment. We have a coin toss. Number 4, Jeremy Serrata, is our other captain for Orofino. So, Orofino has won the toss and has elected to receive this half. Orofino will work south to north in this first quarter. So at kickoff, we have an air quality of 75 and a temperature of 92. Quite pleasant, and the breeze makes it feel even a little bit cooler. Orofino is set. It looks like Jenifer is nearly set. Number 70, Max Gernert, set to kick for the Burrows. Number 24, Cole Madsen, deep to receive for the Maniacs. And at 4:31, we are underway. Kick goes down to about the 30. And Cole makes a number of players miss, returns it back to the 38-yard line, and the Orofino offense will set up there. Thank you. Number three makes a handoff to number 24, Sawyer Barnett, under center, with the handoff to Cole Madsen. For a run and a short gain of about two, we'll set up second and eight. We have a flag on the play. Encroachment called against the Burrows. Looks like that may have occurred on the near side of the line. That'll move it back 5 yards and set up second and three. Number three makes the inside handoff to number 24, who's met immediately and dropped at the line for no gain. Orofino comes up to the line. Another inside handoff to number 24. Met immediately and stopped for no gain. That'll bring up fourth and three on their own 45. And a gain, I believe, by number 24 again. It looks like gain of about five will bring up a first down Orofino. Substitution for Orofino. I believe that was 14 coming in, subbing for number 24. I don't have a 14 on the roster. Cole Madsen, number 24, has been carrying the offensive load for the Maniacs. I believe every play thus far has been a run play to him, so we'll have something different on this play. Inside handoff. Gain of about three. I believe that was Gavin Miller on the carry. Gain of 3 brings up 2nd and 8. Second and 6. Or 7. So Orofino's fairly deliberate here on offense. We're down to about 3.5 minutes here. Quarterback keeper, gain about 1 yard. And we're gonna have a timeout for an injury on this play. It appears to be one of the Orofino players shaken up. Appears to be number 3, Sawyer Barnett, shaken up on the play. He'll come out for at least a play. Coming in is number 2, Caleb Kessinger. We'll wind the clock with 3:10 left in this first quarter. And a large gain on that play. Out across the 40, and that'll be a first down Orofino. Quarterback keeper near side, met by number 7 in the backfield for a loss. Good job by Christian Spruill, meeting him for a loss of about 3 on the play. Timeout taken by Jenifer. We'll stop the clock with 1:52 in this first quarter. Thank you. Welcome back to this second quarter of action. 15 back to pass. Has 84 open on the left side. Cameron Martin open, but ball thrown just a little bit deep. So that will bring up second and 10 from the 28-yard line. Number 15 under center for the Burrows. Looks to pass left. Completed to number 41 on the left sideline. Slips a few tackles, still on his feet. And finally brought down. It looks like the ball may have come loose. Recovered by Orofino, number 70. Ray Stars with the fumble recovery. And that will set up Orofino, first and 10, from about the 11-yard line. Correction, the 9-yard line. So as the offensive and defensive squads switch, the officials call for the Orofino ball. And this Orofino possession will start with 9:44 left in this second quarter. Late substitution. A little bit of confusion on the Jenifer sideline. Ball on the ground. Recovered by Orofino. Looks like maybe a loss of a portion of a yard. We'll still call it second and 10. So we've crossed the 9-minute mark. Bringing up second and 10. Looks like possibly 24 again running out to the left side. Good run. Brought down after a loss, after a gain of about 6 yards. We'll bring up third down and 4. Third and about 4 from their own 15-yard line. Inside handoff to 24. He breaks a tackle, breaks another arm tackle. He's got some room. Finally brought out of bounds by number 70. Max Gernert with the tackle. But that's enough for a first down, setting up the Maniacs. First and 10 on their own 46. So content to let the clock run quite a ways. We're down to 7 minutes, 20 seconds. And Orofino's been taking just that full play clock on every play. Number three under center. Looks to pass. Pass intended for number 80. Incomplete. Jackson Rupee, the intended receiver. And he had about four burrows right around him on that play. Incomplete pass will stop the clock with 6:52. And bring up second and 10 from the 47. Three drops back, decides to tuck it down and run. Has some room, out to the 40. Gain of 13 on the play is enough for a first down. Timeout taken by Orofino. Right, welcome back from the timeout. That will set up Orofino on their own 40, on the 40-yard line. Good penetration by 66. And then a nice team tackle by 6 and 21 for your Burrows. Rylan Keller and Junior Moody there for the tackle. That'll be a loss of 7 on the play, bringing up 2nd and 17. Orofino comes up to the line of scrimmage. Number three with the inside handoff. Met pretty early, gain of about 2 on the play. We'll bring up 3rd down and 15. A lot more fans have come down this afternoon. We're probably at 200 plus here on the Jenifer side. Third and 15 for Orofino. Back to pass. Defense forces him inside. First man there is 15, Dallas Richardson, for the sack. Loss of two on the play. Brings up fourth and 17. Now under 4 minutes left in this second quarter. Dropping back to pass. Breaks a few tackles and then gang tackled after a gain of about five. So, failing to get the first down will result in a turnover on downs. Your Burrows will take over first and 10 on their own 43. And this possession will start with 3 minutes, 27 seconds left in this second quarter. Number 75, Carson Merle, bringing in a play for the offense. Number 17, under center. Pitch back. Number 43, who's met quickly by number 70, Ray Stars, for the Orofino Maniacs. Results in a loss of about 3 on the play, bringing up 2nd and 13. .245 left in this second quarter. Pass to the right side, complete to number 13, who's met immediately. Gain of about 5 on the play. Drew DeGroot with the good reception. And good coverage by Orofino to stop him there and prevent any further gain. That'll bring up 3rd and 8. Third and 8, under 2 minutes left in this second quarter. Fakes a pass to the left side, pulls it down, and is immediately met by a host of Orofino defenders. Loss on the play, back to about the 38. Timeout taken by your Burrows. Offense! And Jenifer comes out of their huddle after the timeout. A minute 38 left in this second period. Number 15 takes the snap. Pass complete to 21 on the near side. Makes a man miss. And drags a number of defenders with him out to the 45 across midfield for a first down Burroughs. Burroughs hurrying it along with a minute 20 left in this first half. Officials pause things for, I believe, some of the officials to get set. Long snap, number 21. Runs out to the right side. Long gain. Out across the 30. That will bring up another first down Burroughs. So they'll start this play on about the 26. Bit of a high snap, corralled, handed off 21. Appears to be a gain down to gain of about 8 on the play. And I believe we have a timeout taken by Jenifer. If my math's correct, that's their third and final timeout of this half. Second down on the 18. And the completion is good for our first down. 16 seconds left. Number 17 under center. Drops back. And is met by a host of defenders. Wrapped up. That will end this first half. So at the end of the first half, score is 7 for your Jenifer Burroughs, 0 for the Orofino Maniacs. We're going to have a 10 to 15 minute halftime. The Jenifer 7th grade is done for the day. the Jenifer 8th grade will come out, get warmed up, stretched, and return. All right, and welcome back to this second half of action. It appears that we're going to score these as two separate games, two separate two-quarter games. In the first half, seventh grade Burroughs scored 7 against the combined 7th, 8th Maniacs from Orofino. Maniacs were scoreless. So our captains for the Burroughs, number 4, Andrew Haynes, number 3, Michael Earl, number 32, Reese Bacon, and number 8, Trayton Burke. Orofino won the toss and has elected to receive. Orofino will work south to north. Orofino 8th grade is coached by offensive coordinator Darren Ulrich, defensive coordinator Pat Zink, and head line coach Josh Moore. Kick is away. Down to about the 20. Met by defenders, return of about 8, and a flag on the play. Officials confer and pick the flag up. Orofino will start their possession, 1st and 10, on their own 28-yard line.
Let
First offensive play of this third quarter. Handoff inside. Gain of about one. We'll call that a gain of two. And an Orofino player shaken up on the play. Appears to be number two. Caleb Kessinger shaken up on the play. And we'll step away while they address the injured player. And welcome back. Number 24 for Orofino, shaking up on that play. Cole Madsen. And that could be a fairly large loss for the Maniacs. We've also discovered that we're doing 8-minute quarters in this second half. So there's currently 7 minutes, 43 seconds in this third quarter. And Orofino's ready. Number 3 drops back. Met in the backfield by number 54 for the Burrows. Griffin Gilbertson with the sack. Loss back to about the 22. Loss of 5 on the play. Brings up 3rd and about 15. Flag on the play, 5-yard penalty against the Maniacs. Bring up 3rd and along about 20. Number 3, back to pass. Short inside pass. Met immediately by a couple Burrow defenders. Play results in a loss of about 3. And we have 4th down from about the 25. Orofino needs to get to the 38 for a first down. Kick is away, covered at about the 30. Long return, down inside the 5. So the Burrows will have a short field, first and goal from about the 4. Number 4 under center. Pitch back. Number 22 with the 4-yard run. Caden Cox Touchdown, Burrows. And with 5:29 left in this third quarter, score is Burrows 6, Maniac 0. And number 3, back to kick. Michael Earl. Ty Collins holding. Kick is up. It is good. Two-point kick makes the score now 8-0 with 5:29 left in this third quarter. Appears at 56, Grady Helm is set to kick for the Burrows. Kick is fielded at about the 25, short return of about 3. Orofino will start this possession on their own 26-yard line. And here in this second possession of the half for Orofino, pass intercepted by number 1. Returns to about the 15, but a flag on the play. I believe that was a holding call on Jenifer. And that will negate the interception. Correction, holding during the return. Jennifer will retain possession. First and 10 from the 32. Number 4, Andrew Haynes, under center. Handoff, near side, has a corner, And a good run by number 10, Corbin Gilmore. Gains down to about the 6-yard line. Brings up first and goal. Trips left, one right. Pass complete to number 3. Touchdown, Burrows. Michael Earl with the reception. Kick is up, and good. So with point after kick, the score now becomes 16 for your Jenifer Burrows, 0 for the visiting Orofino Maniacs. And welcome back. 4:14 left in the third quarter. Burrows 16. Maniac 0. The kick is away. Covered at the 25. And met immediately. Number 32, Reese Bacon, with excellent coverage. Flag on the play. False start against the offense. Moving back 5, bringing up 1st and 15. Clock remains stopped at 4:09. F-O-V-E-Movement. Girls, get to it. F-O-V-E-Movement. Number 3 hands off to number 54, who's met in the backfield. Colby Castro with the carry. Loss of about a yard on the play. And timeout taken by Orofino. Second and 16. Number 3 looking to make a pass. Pass intended for number 14. Incomplete. That'll bring up third and 16 for the Orofino Maniacs. Incomplete pass, stop the clock at 3:49. And a flag comes in. False start on the offense. We'll move them back another 5, bringing up third and about 21. So 2 false starts have not been the friend of the Maniacs today on this possession. Looks like a loss of about 1 on the play. Brings up 4th and 22 from the 19-yard line. Thank you.
Kick goes away. Takes an Orofino friendly bounce.
Across the 50 to the 48. And Jenifer will take over there. So the Burrows will take over, 3:19 left in this third quarter. First and 10 on their own 48. Number four back, looks to pass. Pass complete. Breaks a tackle, number eight does, but steps out of bounds. Good catch and run by Trayton Burke. Steps out of bounds at the 15-yard line, but enough for the first down. First and 10 from the 25. Hitch back to number 10. Nobody home on defense. And a fairly easy run in for number 10, Corbin Gilmore. 25-yard run. Results in a touchdown, Burrows. Kick is up and good. So with the kick good for two, that makes your score now 28 for your Burrows, 0 for the visiting Orofino Maniacs. Kick is away. Nice deep kick, fielded at the 20. It's got some room. Out across midfield.
And the Maniacs will start this possession, first and 10, from the Jenifer 44. Number three, inside handoff to 32. And that's enough for a Orofino first down. First and 10 for Orofino on the 39-yard line. Handoff. Tripped up quickly. Number two with the carry, Caleb Kessinger. No gain on the play. And off to number 32, met in the backfield by 54. Griffin Gilbertson, with the tackle for loss, will end this third quarter. So after three, the score is 24 for the Burrows, 0 for the visiting Orofino Maniacs. And Jenifer will start the fourth quarter.
Ladies and gentlemen, this intermission time, we'd like to introduce our year-long athletes at Jenifer, the toughest athletes we know, the cheerleaders. Please help me welcome Abby Jill Ramos, Gracelyn Bonner, Haley Steiner, Kaylee Starbuck, Marissa Tank, Mia Parisi, Paige Leeson, Tamina Granger, Bella Cashin, Izzy Titus, Kelsey Hartley, Jimmy Nielsen, Ava Ander, Hallie Lehman, Paul Lighty, and Kaylee Stahofsky. And our JMS coaching staff, Ms. Max Severson, Ms. Burke Binkley, and Ms. Tammy Parisi.
And we're underway in this fourth quarter. Fake handoff by number three. Keeps it. Looks like a gain of about one on the play. Bringing up fourth down and 13. Number three eludes one tackler, but number 61, Keaton Lytle, is there to make the tackle. Just got an announcement from the official that we're going to proceed with a running clock at this point. 6:50 left in this fourth quarter. Number four and a shotgun. Looks to pass. Pass complete, near side to number eight. Trayton Burke with the catch and run. But number 10, Gavin Durkin for Orofino, hangs on and brings him down. First down, pass to the right side. Quite a bit of room for number 10. And he will go all the way. Touchdown, Burroughs. And the kick is away. Over number 20. Goes back to cover it. Short return. And Orofino will start this possession, first and 10, on about the 10-yard line. With a gain of about 3 on the first play, Orofino is looking at 2nd and 7. Handoff, met immediately. Number 51 with the stop for Jennifer, Jackson Keller. So loss of a couple on the play brings up 3rd and about 7. Whistle comes in. False start called against the Orofino Maniacs. That'll move them back 5 yards. And bring up 3rd and about 12.
I'm a year younger than Brogan. Wait, you thought I was an 8?
I thought you were an 8.
Did Brogan know I didn't tell you? No, I'm trying to tell you.
Wait, you
talked to me over the phone. Yeah, because me and Cassie are the only reason we're all brought together because we went
down. Short gain on the play.
My dead name's the same exact name.
Of about 1 yard. Correction, about 3. Brings up 4th and 9. Back to kick. Kick goes away. Takes a decent bounce out to the 32.
Hey,
So with 32 seconds left in this quarter, score is 30-0 in favor of your Jenifer Burrows. First and 10, and 33, and a kneel down. And the kneel down will end the game. Thank you for those who tuned in today for the contest between the Orofino Maniacs and your Jenifer Burrows. And that is our final buzzer. I believe the final score was 30-0, depending on whether an extra point that I missed was good or not. So your Burrows will next be in action. Seventh grade will play on the 13th here against Lincoln Middle School of Clarkston at 4 o'clock. And we're looking forward to bringing you that game, if all goes as expected. Thank you for tuning in. Remember, it's a great day to have a great day. Good night, and God bless.